The specter of Ariel led me to Willendorf. If I was to defeat the next member of the Circle, I needed to understand his machinations. With this vague advice in mind, I set forth on the road to Willendorf.
Strange, isn't it, Kain, that one cannot quite accept that which sustains him. You in your death, and me in mine. But death cannot reign in a world without life, and soon you will find the quest ahead of you is yours and yours alone. I can assist you no longer.
Willendorf, proud defender of the realm with its warrior elite and mighty ruler, King Otmar. The Lion Throne had once held my allegiance, but Willendorf's days of glory had passed. It was the last bastion against an unruly future.
Thank you.
Spell, I can tear a creature's soul from its body, leaving its vacant flesh mine to control.
Thank you.
Mighty Willendorf had sliced open the belly of the earth, reaping a bounty of precious metals and unearthing ancient secrets. Of these secrets, I had heard of a tomb that contained an ancient forefather of King Otmar himself. Within the tomb, a fountain of blood would allow me to cast the most noble of illusions and gain entry to the city of the Mighty Lion.
The blood of ages flows so sweet. Come, drink from us. Your strength has increased, for our blood enhances.
Oh.
The blood of ages flows so sweet. Come, drink from us. Your magic energy recovers more quickly, for our blood enhances.
Ugh! Thank you.
blood of ages flows so sweet. Come, drink from us.
Unlike the mask of disguise, this spell actually allows me to cast away the guise of death for a time, allowing me to walk among the living undisturbed. The spell also provides a visage of nobility, for there are many who would easily divulge more to those of highborn blood. Mighty Willendorf had sliced open the belly of the earth, reaping a bounty of precious metals and unearthing ancient secrets. Of these secrets, I had heard of a tomb that contained an ancient forefather of King Otmar himself. Within the tomb, a fountain of blood would allow me to cast the most noble of illusions and gain entry to the city of the Mighty Lion.
Thank you. shed your blood for me, and these artifacts will be yours. So, you come to the Spirit Fort for help, do you, vampire? Trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will. So, you come to the Spirit Fort for help, do you, vampire? Trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will. Trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will.
Antitoxin. Slow time.
Shed your blood for me, and these artifacts will be yours. So, you come to the Spirit Fort for help, do you, vampire? Trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will. So, you come to the Spirit Fort for help. Vampire, trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will. So, you come to the Spirit Fort for help, do you, vampire? Trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will. Trade your secrets for the blood of the dead, I will.
The great library of Willendorf, filled with dull tomes of trite accounts by pompous historians about matters that couldn't possibly be of interest to anyone but themselves. The book spoke of the birth of the circle. The circle served the pillars, protectorates to the strange power that gives life to our land. At the unlikely death of a member, The circle remains broken for a time until the pillars can cull a worthy successor. I came upon another book of interest, buried deep amongst the library tomes. It spoke of a small cult that existed in Nosgoth ages past. Wherever they travelled, strange tales of human possession would follow. Little is known of the god they worshipped.
Please help me, kind sir.
Thank you. The court of King Otmar. Shades of my former existence. Proud and self-absorbed. Surrounded by all the finery of the realm. Secure in their ignorance. As I walked among them, I smirked, thinking of the carnage that would befall them at the hands of the legions of the Nemesis, the glorious flames, and the inevitable rape and pillage. Out of my way, peasant! The stench of the fields hangs over you like a pall.
The king sees no one. He is in mourning for the princess.
He'll be in mourning for his kingdom soon, and he'll mourn for you even sooner if you don't get out of my way!
Ooh!
And so I won my audience, such as it was, with Otmar. He cared not for the invading armies from the north, only of the plight of his child.
Her birthday present. To celebrate her birthday, I declared a contest. Whoever created the finest doll in the realm would be granted a royal favor. Hundreds of dolls were brought, but the winner was obvious. Elzevir, the doll maker, created a toy of such beauty that all were captivated by it. And all he would take in payment was a lock of her hair. Soon after, she became like this, a lifeless puppet. Whoever restores her to her former self shall have this kingdom.
Thus, my hunt for the dollmaker began.
My daughter. I fear I shall never hear her delicate laugh again. Oh.
Otmar slumped on his throne like a rag doll, his beard matted with tears of his own self-pity. In my court, he would have long since been usurped by one stronger, but in Willendorf, they worshipped him, even in his weakness. I wondered what Willendorf would do when Otmar's death finally arrived. Through whispers of the court, I learned that the Army of the Last Hope, Willendorf's proud militia, was in no condition to fight the invading legions of the Nemesis. They were busy scouring the lands to the north in search of the Dollmaker and Otmar's daughter. I also learned of a tunnel, which would take me rapidly from Willendorf to the suspected area.